Hi there. Now, if you're a young Nigerian, this is something you'll find very interesting. Five weird things Chinese people are looking for in Nigeria. Now, it's certainly no longer surprising to see Chinese people everywhere. On the bus, in the taxi, on Okada, trekking the streets, they are everywhere. As a matter of fact, the influx of everyday Chinese people into Nigeria is on a rapid increase. Now, regular Chinese people, not big businessmen, I'm talking about regular everyday Chinese people, are coming into Nigeria on a daily basis with no plan to go back in a hurry. Why will this Chinese man now get up in the morning, take a shower, board the plane and fly 10,000 kilometers to Nigeria with just a hand luggage? And after a few months, he's phoning his cousins to do the same. It will surprise you to know that the average Chinese man has traveled the length and breadth of Nigeria more than the average Nigerian. He has entered the north, he has entered the south, he has entered the east, he has entered the west by road, by train, by boat, by plane, by every means. The average Chinese man has traversed the length and breadth of Nigeria more than the average Nigerian. So, what in the world are they looking for? Well, I've asked myself that same question, and here are five things Chinese people are looking for in Nigeria that you probably should be interested in. The first is pigs. Chinese people have gone from community to community to buy pigs. And what do they do with it? Of course, they eat it. China is the world's largest consumer of pork. So they source for these pigs and they know how to get it across to their own local markets. It's big business for them. Another thing they are looking for in Nigeria are donkeys. Back at China, they use donkey skin to make a local traditional medicine called ijiao. So these guys are on a wild hunt for donkey skin. As a matter of fact, recently the Nigerian government had to ban the exportation of donkey skin to keep the animal from going extinct, and I'm in full support of that. Now, one other thing that Chinese people are combing the country in search of are cashews. Of course, cashew nuts are big on the international market, and there's quite a lot of it in Nigeria. So these guys you see around are harvesting this gold from local farmers and sending it out or adding value to it right here in Nigeria. And finally, these Chinese people are entering the most remote communities in search of cassava. Like cashew, you should know by now that cassava is big on the international market, and Chinese people use it for food, they use it for a wide range of industrial products, they use it for animal feed as well. So, you might see these Chinese people on the bus in faded clothes and cheap canvas. They are simply dressed for the job and they are smiling to the bank, I can assure you. Now, the big question is this. If this Chinese man gets on a plane, leaves China, comes to Nigeria and crisscrosses the country exploring opportunities in the most unlikely places and in the most amazing ways, then what in the world are you still doing at home? So when next you see that Chinese man on the streets, don't get mad, get busy. Stop using your degree and start using your head.